posture, flat feet, sub knees, release the tailbone, roll the shoulders down and back, chest lifted, bring the right ear to right shoulder. And roll it on over to the left.
Rotate one foot.
top of the foot. Chatter. So if you're dancing and you're like, oh man, I can't get this, it feels weird, I look stupid, oh, can't have that. It doesn't go in here. And so since we're not doing it to ourselves and we're not doing it to each other, so if you're having a hard time with the way your moves are going, watch somebody that's getting it, be inspired by them, and it'll be a silent compliment to them. So we'll be like, oh, I must be doing it all right because someone's looking at me. So we'll just keep that idea in there. And as soon as that thing comes, I will know and I will get it. So this is the most talking that we ever do on the first night. And can somebody explain to those that don't know what American tribal style belly dance is? Karen.
Well, American tribal style belly dance is improv. It's group improvisational dance, but when done with a group of people who know the moves, it will look choreographed. You always have a leader in the group, and they will cue the moves, and the followers follow, and it looks really cool.
That's right. And you can wipe your brow with your costume with cotton rather than chiffon. So, let's get back to the mirror and get dancing. So the way that the first class goes is we're just going to kind of get through a bunch of moves to get a feel for things. And then over the course of the series, we'll break things down. We'll break a couple things down tonight. And, okay, let's get into posture. Flat feet. Soft knees, release the tailbone. It's a neutral tailbone. You want to do like a crunch. And so the crunch is protecting the low back. Your weight's in your heels. You roll the shoulders down and back. And chest is lifted. So, we're going to stay in this posture Well, throughout our dance, and first thing we're going to learn is the toxine. And it looks like this. So side to side. But first, let's just start with our weight in one leg. Kind of like you're waiting for your friend, and you're like, okay, where is she? You switch. Oh my gosh. I'm so bored. Just switch your weight. And notice that when your leg is straight, that makes the hip rise. And when the knee is bent, the hip is down.
Thank you.
bar. We practice this one every week. A little tricky.
Thank you.
Bring the left arm forward, linking at our hips. One option for the arms, or I should say arm, the flurry up. And the taxi. Do with our arms is the snake arm, it's also known as the arm undulation. It looks like that. Eventually we'll have it with the toxin, the whole thing together, it's looking like this. Let's just start with one arm. So remember, you're in your mannequin arm to start, and then imagine there's a string connected to the point of your elbow and it's being pulled up to the ceiling, which would allow your hand to drag on the wall behind you. Then release and paint the wall to your right. There's an imaginary countertop here, so your fingers just brush that. Lift and release. And make sure that your arm is coming straight out. You don't want the elbow back. That's too much. It's painful. Just straight out. So you're lifting. Take it up into vertical, still leading with the elbows. Breathe. Weight in your heels. And up the hips. If you just want to focus on the arms, that's okay too. So the hips go to the left and the elbows to the left. So the elbow and the hip are connected. Right elbow and hip, left elbow and hip. turning. Mentioned to as a clean ATS is that what's really cool is that people all over the world are learning this dance, and so essentially people that are learning in other places can dance with us once they learn all the moves and the cues and stuff. And what's awesome is we just started the online classes, so already we have somebody in Sarasota, Florida. We have, I think it was somebody in Canada, there's someone in Philadelphia, there's even local, there's a woman in Edmonds, there's one in Basel, they're like all over. I should bring the list every week and say who's joining us, because it's kind of cool. And so if those people ever happen to be in town, they can dance with us and they'll know the dance. And you can also check out studios in other states when you're traveling, and you should be able to dance with people there too. So it's really cool. It's a good way to make new friends in foreign places. So we're going to move into our fast steps. So grab water if you need to. And shake. Right, left, right, left.
Yeah.
recipe now. Good. Turn to me.